Worried about next year.
Already?
What else is there to do?
What does it mean to you to be a world champ?
It's probably the second best thing that's ever happened to me. Got my little boy, and after that, I mean, this is, just incredible. Do it with this team, to show the guts and the courage, and I mean, this team, I'm just happy.
What do you have to say to Red Sox fans?
Congratulations, there you go.
What do you have to say to Red Sox?
Well, that is interesting to see Keith Foulke with champagne on his hat saying, can't wait till next year. Normally, we just say, wait till next year this time of year. So, big twist tonight, and we're very happy to see it.
I love it. We love looking at that stuff. Well, let's go back live up to Doug Meehan, who is in Sky Fox. Doug, how does it look out there?
Well, Maria and David, what Angelica couldn't really see from her vantage point and why it seems that there's less people around Fenway Park is because before the folks started to bail out of the bars down here and gather at Kenmore Square, the police put up these barricade lines of human shields, if you will. We are down on the lower end of Brookline Avenue. You may recognize the movie theater on the left-hand side. Moments ago, there was a large number of fireworks that just went off. And now you've got the motorcycle, there's the video right there of the fireworks that were going off just moments ago right where we are. There's a large crowd that's gathered just in front of the movie theater here, and the Boston police have rolled in with the motorcycle units as well as officers on foot in full riot gear just behind them. It appears that you still have people dancing in the streets, but the police have acted and acted fast. They're not waiting around like they did the other night when the Red Sox clinched against the Yankees. They are moving in and moving in fast, but as you can see, some still decide and think it's a game, but they'll find out as soon as the police roll up on them that it isn't. It can be a very dangerous situation, as we found out. But as you can see, a large crowd has congregated on this end of Brookline Ave, and heavy police presence just keeps pushing this crowd down to this lower intersection here. And it'll be interesting because you still have plenty of traffic that's moving through this intersection on the lower end of Brookline. They've done the same thing further north from here, closer to Kenmore Square, but this is a situation that the police have moved and moved fast on. We'll continue to keep an eye on things. That we did see one person that was put on the back of a stretcher and put on the back of an ambulance. We don't know the extent of their injuries, but there have been some injuries already taking place out here.
Doug, this is a much different scene than we saw last week after we beat the Yankees.
Well, considerably, because what they did is they did not allow folks to cross the bridge. Well, they crossed the bridge from Kenmore Square over to Fenway Park, but they stopped them right there, what is the Caskin Flagon. They stopped them right there. They weren't able to go down Yawkey Way, and they've cut half the traffic off, foot traffic down, lands down. So they're keeping these groups considerably separated, but I can tell you the pockets of people are considerably larger than they were for Game 7 against the Yankees. But again, the Boston police are moving a lot faster than they did for that situation. Yeah, back to you guys in house.
You can see that. All right, Doug, thank you.
Thank you, Doug. We want to head back down to St. Louis now. Butch Stearns is on the field, and he is hanging out with Tim Wakefield. Butch?
Thanks, David and Maria. Tim and Stacy Wakefield here. Congrats, Wake.
Thanks.
I mean, you've been through a lot with this team. You've been here the longest. I mean, it's got to be an emotional time.
It is an emotional time for me and Stacy. You know, having our backs against the wall the way we did, the way we won this thing is just phenomenal. It's so surreal, and it's like a dream come true.
How proud are you of Tim State?
I can't even say. This is probably the proudest moment I've had.
How about you guys, the wives, watching the games here? I mean, a four-game sweep was great. There wasn't a lot of drama to worry about.
Well, you always get nervous if it comes seventh, eighth, ninth inning. You tend to say, oh, no, just keep it going and believe it's going to happen.
How about all these things?
It's phenomenal. It's phenomenal. You come to St. Louis thinking you're going to get a lot of St. Louis fans, and we have a lot of Red Sox fans here. It's in the 10 years that I've been playing here, you know, these people show up wherever we go. It's phenomenal. I mean, we got Red Sox fans all over the country.
Congrats, Wake. Seriously, you're a world champ, man. Stacy, congrats. All right. So, Tim Wakefield, the Red Sox fans, thousands of them, chanting, thank you, Red Sox, behind us. Larry Lucchino, it's going to be over here in just a second. It's a mob scene, folks. There's Larry right there. I got Larry coming over right now. Larry! comes. Larry Lucchino coming over, the Red Sox president.
All right, Butch.
All right, I'll tell you what. I'll go get him and I'll come back. Why don't I throw it back to you?
All right, Butch, we'll go back to you in just a couple of minutes. Unbelievable scene down there.
It is great. Well, the game was won there in St. Louis. We are World Series champions, but we are celebrating and we are proud here in Boston.
That's right. Let's head out to Boston again. Fox 25's Dan Janig was just in the thick of things in the crowd of people celebrating in Kenmore Square, and looks like people are having fun so far, Dan.
That's right, David. You know, I won't be long, because when Butch Stearns calls Larry Lucchino over, you know Larry Lucchino has to come right away, especially when it's Butch Stearns. Here at Fenway Park, just let me show you the scene here behind me. Nothing is happening here on Yawkey Way. Can we pan over there, Nate? Okay. Nothing happening here on Yawkey Way. They basically barricaded off these streets. It's in front of me, in behind that camera right there on Boylston Street, where hundreds of students and hundreds of people have gathered. I just actually walked through that crowd. And I want to show you some video we took as we're going through there. Okay, there's a couple of people on top of a television news truck, and you're about to see a couple of people that set off some fireworks in the crowd right there. But it overall, it's actually pretty peaceful. We were walking through the crowd, people giving high fives to each other. There is a line of state police in riot gear along Boylston Street, keeping everybody in check. But I've been out there for about a good 40 minutes, maybe a half hour, and I've seen no incidents whatsoever, at least on that stretch of Boylston Street, where at least hundreds of students have gathered. So at least right now, 12:30 in the morning, things are very electric down here, but peaceful, at least here on the Boylston side of things here. David, Maria?
And Dan, what kind of things are you seeing? In the video, we could see some people with brooms, obviously, making reference to the fact that the Red Sox swept the Cardinals. Actually, let me pause that question for a second. We're going to try to go back to you. In the meantime, we want to head back to St. Louis because Fox 25's Butch Stearns is standing by with Kurt Schilling. Butch?
No, I don't have Schilling. He's behind me. I'm trying to get him, so let me throw it back to you, and I'll try and get him in a second, okay?
All right, we're juggling all kinds of things here tonight, so let's go back to Dan, and as soon as Butch grabs Kurt, we'll go to him. Dan, if you can still hear me out there outside of Fenway Park, give me an idea of what kind of things you're seeing the people doing. We saw the brooms to represent the sweep over the Cardinals. What kind of things are they chanting? What kind of things are they doing?
Okay, you'd think that after winning the World Series against St. Louis, they'd be chanting things about St. Louis, but they are chanting down with the Yankees here around Fenway Park. Of course, this has been a long, long battle for Red Sox Nation. As you can see in these live Sky Fox pictures, there are hundreds of people here gathering. They have signs, David, that say the curse is through. The curse is over. There are at least, I was out there, I may have counted about 20 people who must have taken brooms from their homes. Live camera on the ground there for a second. Now back to Sky Fox, and you can see hundreds of people, but basically, you know, all in good fun. There's no bottles out there that we've seen. There's no problems out there. Police haven't been involved in any problems that I've seen, and I was actually in the middle of this crowd that you're looking at right now. Just a lot of signs, a lot of high fives, strangers hugging each other, people crying, calling their family. If they go to school here, calling their family in California and let them know that this is an electric day, a historic day here in Boston. David, Maria?
All right, Dan. Probably we'll check back in with you.
Probably tough to make a cell phone call at this point. Everyone's on the cell phone.
Oh, yes.
Got to call your family members, got to call all your friends and talk to them about this big win. We want to head back to St. Louis now. We have more sound from the locker room right after the win. Let's listen in.
I have to say to Red Sox fans, you know what they've gone through all these years.
Congratulations. I just want to say congratulations. This is all for all of us. All of you, all of us, everyone in the New England area, everyone, generation after generation after generation, we are glad that we were the ones to usher it home to you.
You told us in the pregame you dreamt about this. What's your next dream going to be?
I don't know.
You better tell him.
I can get a key to the city.
what do you have to say to Red Sox fans?
Finally, we don't have to listen to 1918 anymore. And they can go home and smile for the rest of their lives.
Today's game seven. You know, we didn't want the scene to go any further. And so, you know, we kept telling each other, this is game seven. You know, we don't want, you know, it's a must win. We had to go out there and give it all we had because we don't want to give this city and this lineup another day. And to pull it off is unbelievable.
It is unbelievable.
It is. Well, we just heard the chants behind Butch Stern saying, Thank you, Red Sox. And we can hear them all the way here, Boston, and in Foxborough.
Let's go back to Fox 25's Debbie Robin. Debbie, are they still screaming in your earpiece there or what?
It's crazy in here, I'll tell you. I want to introduce you to a fan that did not have to wait a lifetime to see the Red Sox win. This is young Henry, 3 months old. How big of a fan is Henry?
This is Henry. His favorite player is David Ortiz.
All right, David Ortiz from Young Henry here. He's a fan, and all of these fans have been here tonight but people are overwhelmed, and they say all good things come to those who wait, and tonight it definitely happened. David, Maria?
All right, Debbie, thank you very much.
All right, we want to head back to St. Louis. Butch is on the field, and we are told that he has someone with him. Butch?
All right, we're back here on the field. Guests are on the way, but let me throw it back to the scene in the locker room. It was tremendous.
I went through a lot of drama during the winter, but, you know, I keep my mind positive, and I told my wife before the season started, hey, baby, this is going to be my year, you know, this is the year. And we did it, man. We the champ. I want to get the ring, and I have it. You know, that's something that nobody's going to take it away from you. You know, when the other stuff, you never know when you're going to get it, but I'm just blessed, you know, to be the MVP and to win a World Series. I think God be blessing me with a lot of stuff, you know, my two kids, my wife, everything. I have it all, you know. It's nothing that I can complain about.
Well, we're a really good team, and we did it in style. You know, we played, we won 45 of our last 60, I think, down the stretch against great teams. And, you know, I think history will reflect that, but it really doesn't matter how it gets done. It's the fact that it is done. And a lot of people can die happy now. A lot of people can live happy now. And time to celebrate a little bit.
It was unbelievable because they have one of the best offenses in the league, and they show it all the way to the regular season. And then, you know, I mean, our pitching, we got a great pitcher star, and we play great defense.
Sometimes in a short series, I mean, you catch guys at the right time. And it's, I mean, again, we won tonight. We didn't allow, you know, roll, and those guys are going to get hot. We didn't allow them the chance to get hot. So, you know, good for us.
All right, we're back on the field. Larry Lucchino will be with us in just a second. I tell you, it is a mob scene here, but they are well-behaved. People are just celebrating like crazy. We've had VB in the locker room. I've been in the locker room. We're getting guests out here on the field. And fans are just, they're doing an unbelievable job, I'll tell you right now. And the families are all here. Here comes Larry Lucchino right now, the Red Sox president. They promised. Thank you, Larry. Finally. I mean, it's a mob scene trying to get everybody out here. You promised when you stepped to that podium in the Diamond Room in Fenway just 3 years ago to deliver a World Series, and you did it as an owner.
Well, thank you. That was December 21, 2001, and I know people were a little unsure about us and a little skeptical about what we would bring to the franchise, but we have the zeal of the convert. We love New England. We love this franchise, and we are really happy to be able to deliver to Red Sox Nation and to the heart and soul of Red Sox Nation, which, of course, is New England.
What do you have to say to these Red Sox fans here and Red Sox fans all back in New England?
I have to say that it's not a BS. It is really true that their energy, their passion, their support, their inspiration does make a difference in the performance of this team. It gives us financial wherewithal. It inspires the players. It fills the ballpark with the kind of electricity. They make a difference, and that is absolutely true. We share, of course, this moment with all of them.
And tonight's a night to celebrate, but you know what? For you and John and Tom and Theo, you wake up tomorrow morning, you got to go back to work. You got a two-week window to make a lot of tough decisions.
Yeah, but it's a labor of love, I will tell you, and this makes it even more a labor of love.
Congratulations, Larry.
Thank you, Butch.
All right, you really earned it. Thank you. Larry Lucchino, the Red Sox president. Let me throw it back to you, and we'll get some more guests over here.
All right, Butch. Butch is going to be grabbing interviews on the field there throughout the rest of this night. We still have so much more Red Sox coverage for you tonight.
Yes, but first, check out these moments that we will never forget.
Continuous soft rock and lyrics that won't embarrass.